It's International Women's Day. It's International Women's Month. It's International Women's Year. I'm always celebrating great women. And I was thinking, who better to chat with on such a special occasion than Gauri Devi Dayal of the Table Restaurant in Colaba. Gauri, I'm so excited to be with you.
Thank you for chatting with me on this.
So really, I mean, you just, you know, Gauri, you've had such a great decade, hasn't it? How old is Table now?
Yeah, it's going to be 10 in January. So
that's so amazing. It's been a magical decade for you. It's just been every year you seem to surpass your previous one, isn't it?
No, it's definitely been a whirlwind decade. Definitely more exciting than my previous avatar as a chartered accountant.
What was that switch like? Did you have resistance? How did the family react?
It was a rather unconventional switch for sure. Not your natural next step as a tax consultant. I sort of blame, thank, whatever, you know, my husband as well.
Young people who say, oh, I want to open a restaurant, I want to open a bar. Everyone says that, right? It's the most common dream today. But for you to have just come and done this and to have driven quality and excellence at the level that you have, it's pretty amazing. How did that come about? Was there a moment when it all sort of came together and you sort of had this defining moment where you felt, this is it, I'm on the right path, I've made the right choice and this is going to work out?
You know, I think the only time I really sit back and think about, what's happened so far is when I'm doing sort of talks like this or, having conversations like this rather. And otherwise, you just kind of just keep going, right? It's like, it's what you set out to do. You have a vision and you just keep trying to execute it better every day, and that's literally it.
I resonate so much with what you say, because I always say this to people. You know, I sometimes get asked, and I often say, life always looks great in hindsight. You know, it's like you look back and someone asks you and it always looks so glamorous in hindsight, because you know people think, oh, you've been such a visionary and you've done such a fine.
But you don't think of yourself like that.
You just think, okay, I did what I did, and there was an opportunity, and I took that, and I took a leap of faith, and I sort of went with it, and even I didn't know what lay ahead.
Exactly.
You know, you just do what you do.
I literally neither of us knew what lay ahead, because, you know, we had never been in the hospitality profession before, and, you know, it was one reason for my family to be a little concerned, and they were like, you know, firstly you're working with your husband, and secondly you're doing something neither of y'all know anything about.
Is that difficult, working with a husband?
You know, I mean, honestly, seeing what this business takes, I think it is like a marriage. Even, you know, whoever you're working with, and you have to have a great business partner, whether it's between the chef and the sort of business person, or the two business people in our case.
And trust is so important,
right? Exactly.
So who better to trust than someone? At least you know he's not going to run away,
right?
Or he's not going to cheat you, right?
Yeah, I know where to find him, right?
So you know where to find him. How's the motherhood bit? Is that tough?
That's definitely a challenge. But, you know, I'm not the first working mother in this world. And, you know, I have a great sort of support system, which I'm very lucky to have. And I take full advantage of it, between, you know, parents and sisters and friends and whatnot.
Yeah, so, just exploit everybody around.
Yeah, basically. Like,
just exploit the whole infrastructure.
And, you know, I bring her to work whenever I have to. And I think she's turning out okay. So that's my benchmark for guilt. I say that,
as long as the kids are waking up happy, they're happy going to school, and they're still enjoying their holidays with you, and it's the quality time that matters. Well, let me not prejudice you, but what's your go-to drink?
I'm a little biased. No, I would have to say it's always been wine, and I'm not just saying that because I'm sitting here with you today, but I am, which is why, actually, when we opened the restaurant, for the first 8 months, we only had wine.
Oh, really?
Yes.
And you had no other spirits?
No beer, no spirits.
Oh, interesting. Yeah. And so what made you, it was just people asking for other things?
And also I think that we, it's not about my way or the highway. I mean, you have to recognize that, you know, especially about 9 years ago, India was at a very sort of nascent stage in consuming wine. And, you know, you kind of, you're in hospitality, so you have to be hospitable.
Do you find that changed today? Do you find wine, there's a lot more uptake for wine?
I mean, we have a complete sort of spirits list and we have, you know, beer on the menu as well. But wine is like way up there in terms of what's consumed. And I think it could be because of what we're offering in by way of food as well. Like it pairs better, I think, maybe with wine. But yeah, it's sort of night and day consumption pattern.
Do you think it's sort of time for people to start embracing Indian wines?
Yeah, and you know, I get asked for my suggestions all the time and people are, at, you know, drinking at home. And I'm always saying, I really recommend this Indian wine because it's not... A lot of people also when they're entertaining feel like, oh, you know, I'll be seen as being cheap if I'm serving Indian wine. And that's
so you serve at home?
I serve at home and I recommend it.
What do you recommend? Give me one or two names.
The two of my favorites actually, or three, and I can go on. So one is I love the Cherosa Sauvignon Blanc.
Nice.
I love the new sauce Sauvignon Blanc as well, by Suda. I think the Chen is a great red wine.
Yeah.
So, you know, I just think that
I think these are all wines that have won awards at the India Wine Awards.
Yeah.
So on behalf of our viewers, do you want to ask an FAQ on wine, most frequently asked question? It could be your own question or it could be something that you see a lot being asked around you. But just an FAQ, because we thought through the medium of who I'm chatting with, we could maybe, you know, bust some... whatever, I mean, if at all there is.
So, I mean, you know, I think one thing that I'm seeing sort of, how do you think, you know, what can we as restaurateurs maybe do to boost wine tourism in the city, in the country rather? Because we're in, especially in Bombay, we're within such close proximity of the wineries and we're interacting with consumers every single day.
That's such an amazing question, Gauri.
It's not really out of goodwill or charity. You feed off each other.
It's a collab, isn't it?
Exactly.
It's a collab and it's sort of promoting each other and I mean, you say feed off, but honestly, we co-survive, isn't it? We're all co-dependent on each other. But that's such a great question, honestly, because wine tourism truly excites me. I truly believe that our enthusiasm for wine tourism will probably even out surpass our love for wine someday, because I see so many people wanting to get out and visit wine destinations, whether it's in India or internationally, and they sort of want to experience wine in the most authentic and at its source, you know, at it where the old it all happens. And how can you collaborate? I think for you, the answer is very simple, Gauri. You're such an established table, such an established brand. If you had to just do a pop-up at any winery in India and say that, you know, table
back.
Because what's better than somebody who loves wines or is curious about wine to go to a winery, spend a weekend there and be able to taste some of his favorite foods and more, you know? So for someone like you, it'd be great. Listen, how much fun has this been?
I know.
And
we didn't follow anything on what we were.
Yeah, and I've been drinking. I've been sipping away. I haven't had any sips out of that. But I want to thank you.
Thank you.
For this wonderful chat. Any special message out for women out there who want to take the plunge or want to...
Well, take all the advantage you can as a woman. And, you know, honestly, just work hard, whether you're a man or a woman. And it'll pay off, I promise.
Great. And please listen to Gauri while I'm sipping on this glass of wine. But thank you, Gauri. This has been such great fun. Thank you so much. And before we leave today, Gauri, what I do have for you is these wonderful set. I love giving presents. These wonderful set of Lucaris sparkling glasses for this sparkling conversation for your lively, vivacious personality
Thank
and for sharing so much with us
Thank
today.
You.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.